In this video, we're going to take a look at how you can generate some random fills and then internally resample those for use in your track. So, I've just loaded this sample into a brand new group. Let's just go to sampling and edit. You hear it's quite a long sample. So I'm just going to truncate this a little bit, just so we've got one bar. So there's the start point. Just using the scroll wheel on my mouse to zoom in and out on the sample. Just make sure that we've got that roughly speaking right. Now I can click on truncate. Perfect. So now we need to work out how long that is. You can see because we've got a nice well-cut loop, it's estimated the tempo to be 111, 112. So I'd like to keep the tempo roughly around that. So let's go something like that. And now I am going to be really lazy. I'm just going to slice up the sample. Let's just put it on 8. And I'm just going to click on apply, and that will give me a pattern, which when I hit play, you can hear we've got essentially a MIDI clip that's just regurgitating that sample as it was initially recorded. So let me go shift and double a couple of times, just so that I've got a few bars to try some different rolls over the top of. Cool, okay, so now I am going to go Shift, Effects, Select, and I'm going to go to Stutter. And this is the type of effect that we're going to be experimenting with. So those are the types of things that I'm going to want to record in live and hopefully resample. So let's have a look to see how we can set that up. So I'm going to add a new group. I'm going to go to sampling. Now you can see at the moment, by default, machine will be listening to an external input. I'm going to switch that over to internal, and for the purposes of this, it doesn't really matter which I direct it to. I'm just going to leave it as master. So what we're listening to will be internally resampled. I'm going to leave the recording as a sync start, which means it won't start recording until I hit play. You could also have it as detect, so it's going to detect. I mean, in this instance, sync and detect are by and large the same thing. And we'll just match up the length of the recording with the length of the pattern that I've got. So we'll go to 4 bars. Now I can click on start, and it's going to wait for something to happen, basically. So at this stage, I'm going to navigate back over to group A1. I can just hit restart, and then manipulate the performance parameter. Let's see what we can do. Hit spacebar to stop. Let's go back over to this group, and you can see that we've got a sample now. So let's just click here so we get a new pattern. So we're only going to be listening to group B. Okay, so some of those are cool, some I probably won't end up using. But what I can do now is one final set of slices. Let's go to grid. So maybe set that as eighths and then let's apply that. Okay, so sometimes we've ended up with some fairly normal sounding slices. Sometimes we've ended up with some cool little artifacts that we might use in the main flow of rhythm. Okay, so there you have it, using internal resampling and performance effects to generate some interesting rolls and fills before then rearranging them into something which you ultimately like the sound of for your track.